Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about how to repair a broken solar panel. So a broken solar panel is one of the worst nightmares of a solar enthusiast, and the same has happened with me. So here I have this 350 watt solar panel which is now broken. You can see over here something fell on this, or someone threw something on this. So this area is completely broken, or it's cracked now. It's not exactly broken. So luckily it didn't pass through. My panel still is working, and it was daytime when something fell on that. So the whole glass from here till here is shattered. This portion is more shattered over here. This is still fine, but cracks have appeared all over the place. So I have tested this. We are inside a room right now. I would like to show you, even in a very less light, we are still getting good amount of voltage from this, and you can see it is showing around 25.8 volts right now, without any solar light. Only one tube light is on right now over here. So this should work fine, but the glass which is there on the solar panel is primarily to protect your solar cells. So we need to do something about this so that we can place it outside again, and it does not get destroyed because of moisture, rain and other things. So after some research, we have come to a conclusion that we are going to apply this epoxy, clear epoxy, which is available in the market, or you can buy it from the net. Now when you are going to buy this epoxy, make sure you buy an epoxy which is UV resistant, because you are going to keep your panel outside in the sun, and we don't want this epoxy getting destroyed in the sunlight. Okay, so what do we do before we proceed and apply this epoxy? Now, since the epoxy is going to cover up your solar panel and the cracks, the first thing is, this is already cracked and the efficiency would have been reduced already. So first thing that you need to do is make sure you clean the solar panel properly. There is no dust, dirt or any dirty patches left. Clean it as far as possible. Make sure you don't wet this area too much. So we want to clean the solar panel very nicely, and there shouldn't be any kind of dust, dirt or anything left. Once you have cleaned this, we will proceed with the next part, that is applying the epoxy. So I'm going to clean this properly with the, you can use Collin or some mild cleaning liquid. As I said earlier, make sure you don't spray it on the areas where it is completely broken, or you just spray it on a piece of cloth and clean it off properly. Once I have cleaned it off, we'll start with the procedure of mixing the epoxy, and then we'll apply this on the solar panel. So we are going to clean this now. I'm using a mild towel over here, and Collin, I'll spray Collin on my towel, and we'll try to remove the dirty patches, dust and everything, whatever is possible. Make sure you don't press the panel too hard, because the glass is already cracked, so you have to be extra careful while doing this. So I'm just going to clean this up completely as far as possible. Also be careful while cleaning this, because there will be glass pieces and you could cut your hand, so be very careful while you do this particular process. Okay, so I'll just clean this up and then we'll continue with the remaining part. Okay, so we have cleaned the panel as far as possible. Now the next thing is to prepare the mixture of this epoxy. So usually the epoxy which you'll find comes as two parts, the epoxy and the hardener. So these things are to be mixed in a particular ratio, and this one suggests that the ratio is 3:1. That means 3 parts of this resin and the 3 parts of one part of this hardener. So now I'm going to create a mix of this, and according to the instructions I have to mix it for around 3 minutes, then leave it for around 10 minutes, and then after that we are going to apply it on this. So I'll just take some amount of this. So I'm going to take three of these for the first coat. One part of hardener. Okay, so let's see, I have added this. I'm just going to mix this for some time and then we will continue with the application part later. Okay, so our epoxy mix is ready and we are going to use this wiper, which is available in the market for some 40-50 rupees. You can buy one, and we are going to apply this using this wiper. So the first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it in this area where the maximum glass is broken, and then I'm going to apply a coat all over this. So let's go ahead with this and let's see what happens. Make sure you are sealing it towards the sides so that nothing, any moisture or anything does not get in from these sides. So right now I'm just planning on a first thin coat, and then we'll see a second coat would be necessary or not. Okay, so we have applied a layer of epoxy. I have almost used more than half of it, and you can see now that those cracks are barely visible. This was the area where the actual cracks were. So I have sealed, put more epoxy on this area, and other areas I've just put that epoxy around and wiped it. Now, according to the instructions, it says we have to wait for 24 hours. After that, we'll see if one more coat is required or not, and accordingly, then we'll put this to test in 2-3 days once this is done. Hope this works.